and thanks for your company on the Great Southeast. Well, today I have ventured north of Brisbane to the Sunshine Coast hinterland town of Yamundi. It has a very small population, but yet this place can attract over 1 million visitors each year. You can probably guess where they're headed, and I will join them a little later in the show. But first, I wanted to discover a bit more about the history of this place, and I'm told the Discover Yamundi Centre is the place to start. I'll catch you there later in the show.
We're also catching up with the Brisbane music festival scene. Laurel's making the most of a weekend away in the city, and Martin is getting into some serious four-wheel drive action.
Most weekends, my husband Troy and I like to pack up the car, grab the kids and head to the farm, where I love nothing more than putting on the jeans and the riding boots. But every now and then I crave something a little cosmopolitan, and lucky for me, I know exactly where I can get my fix. Actually, good reminder, I better book the kids into Grandma and Granddad's for the night. Fortitude Valley is home to one of Brisbane's most iconic lifestyle precincts, Emporium. It encompasses the best of the best in accommodation, dining and, yep, shopping. Some of the world's most famous labels line the walls of iconic stores like Tendal, Samantha Ogilvie, Mitchell Ogilvie, Jean Brown, Toscani, and one of my favourites, George Gross and Harry Hu. This duo boasts one of our nation's strongest and most enduring fashion partnerships. They've been going 37 years, and few know them better than regional manager Di Coles.
George and Harry have always been aware of what their customers want, so they're very good at designing each season something new and fresh and always inviting.
Oh, beautiful. Next one.
I think you should try this.
Oh, definitely.
And this. And one more.
Perfect. Perfect.
It's already lunchtime, and under normal circumstances, my tummy would be taking control. You're spoilt for choice around here. The aromas of Mexican, Italian, Moroccan, Asian, and French food in the air. Oh, look, sparkles. The McKinney name is synonymous with jewellery in Queensland, and fourth generation Margot is one of the best. She was recently honoured the Prix de Marie Claire for Australia's Best Fine Jeweller, an accolade added to last year's Best International Opal Jewellery Designer.
I love collecting gems. I think it's in my DNA, and beautiful jewellery. And when we were growing up, we had a department store, and one of the departments was a toy department. So as children, we loved playing in the toy department. Now that we're grown-up girls, we love playing in the jewellery department. Everything that I do is a one-of-a-kind piece of jewellery, and I often am asked to design pieces of jewellery for people, which is something that I love doing. And the gems often do the talking to me, and then I design something around each individual gem.
Naturally, after a morning of shopping, a lady needs time to recoup and regenerate. And well, when in Rome.
When supermodel Kate Moss infamously said, "Nothing tastes as good as skinny feels," she obviously hadn't enjoyed high tea at the Emporium Hotel.
The illustrious Emporium Hotel is the cherry on top, and this, ladies, is why. There are one and two bedroom boutique suites to choose from, and prices start from $279 a night.
Well, the sun has settled on my little farm, and Grandma and Granddad have put the kids to bed, so it's now I can get to enjoy this rare extravagance. I mean, it's just on 8 o'clock. I'm heading out on the town instead of heading to bed. I love this.
When it comes to racing season, it's often horses lapping up the glory. But out at Millmerran next weekend, sheep will be taking centre stage. It's a great day out on Saturday, the 25th of August, with Sideshow Alley, music and fashion. Head to the website for details.
Good afternoon. Tonight in 7 News, residents on alert as firefighters battle to contain an out-of-control backburn. Exclusive, the new plan to ease Brisbane's peak hour congestion. An Ipswich war memorial destroyed by an accused drunk driver. A devastated couple loses everything in a house fire near Gatton. The Prime Minister honours our Olympians. And in flashback, the hydrogen car labelled a hoax and how it shattered Sir Joe's credibility.
What we have in Brisbane is a very healthy model.
Brisbane's enclave boom.
This is Little Africa.
The changing face of our suburbs. Families moving in, others moving out.
I feel like I'm in another country.
Brisbane's cultural revolution, changing the way we live. On Seven's Today Tonight.
Is just around the corner with a McDonald's Happy Meal. Share the moment with your kids today.
At Flight Centre, holidays to Hawaii are on sale now, like Honolulu. Flights and four nights from $1,259. Hawaii, the Big Island. Flights and four nights from $1,319. Kauai, flights and six nights four star from $2,049. Or Maui, flights and three nights from $1,425. And we'll beat any airfare quote or you fly free.
Call 131-600.
Even while asleep, your child never stops growing and developing. Reformulated S26 Gold Toddler has the energy and key nutrients to help fuel his growth and development. S26 Gold Toddler, because they never stop growing.
Right now, the Toyota you want can turn to gold because you qualify for gold fleet discounts normally aimed at big business. It's Toyota-thon. Don't miss your golden opportunity.
You know, I feel like our credit cards are getting away from us. So I was thinking, if only someone could help get them under control. ANZ have options, like transferring our other balances onto one of their credit cards and giving us 12 months at just 2.9% to help get on top of it. And they'll sort out the transfers. It's good to feel in control. In you go. And one bank is thinking the same way.
Swing into McDonald's for a Happy Meal. Get a chicken snack wrap, apple slices and a calcium milk. Plus a cool toy from the new movie Madagascar 3. You could even win a family holiday to meet the Madagascar characters at DreamWorld's new DreamWorks experience. See happymeal.com.au for terms and conditions.
Welcome back to the Great Southeast. I've popped into the Discover Your Mundi Centre, which is in the old Anglican Church on Main Street. It's a museum to this gorgeous little town, manned by volunteers like Phil. Now tell me about this guided walk I should head off on.
Well, it's a self-guided walk, Sophie, designed to get you to see all the heritage sites in town, all the art galleries, and quite a bit of history if you took the trouble to have a look.
Well, I was going to say, most people know Your Mundi for the markets, but there is a lot of history in this little town.
Oh, yes, the old railway line, the logging that used to be here, sugar cane used to be a big industry, all gone, but we've got a record of it here.
It certainly retained its country charm, too.
It has, including most of the characters you're liable to meet down the main street.
Well, I just may meet a few of them.
There's your map.
Thank you.
Have a nice time.
I'll head off and see you later in the show.
That's probably sparked the interest of four-wheel drive enthusiasts out there. And if not yet, then keep watching, because if you're into all things off-road, this is a place that is really going to get your engine revving.
It's an hour and a half from Brisbane to the hallowed 4x4 playground that is Scenic Rim Adventure Park. And if you've been here a couple of years back and you think you know what you're in for, think again. The park has recently moved to a new, larger location in Innes Plain.
Now, the park might be new, but it's going to be a big draw card for four-wheel drivers, because some of these tracks are suitable for beginners and some others are, well, you've got to be a bit more advanced.
Joining me on my off-road adventure is Rob Lawrence. He's a huge fan of the park and has been tackling hill climbs, gullies and ruts around here since the first location opened back in 2009.
So what keeps bringing you back to the park?
Probably the first thing has got to be location of the park. It's the closest park to anyone in the Gold Coast or Brisbane area. In the old days, we used to have to drive anywhere up to 3 hours or more. The second thing now has got to be the ease of access. We can get anything from a standard car in here, pulling a caravan or a camper trailer. Big flat campgrounds now, it's all made it a lot more family orientated.
Rob is also a regular competitor in the various off-road events run at the park, which cater for all levels of driving experience.
The one that I run most regularly here at Scenic Rim would be the Suspension Stuff Challenge. It's really been aimed at the guys with standard or near standard cars as an entry level to learn what it's like competing. Prices are low. One of the probably most important rules is that if you don't want to drive an obstacle, you don't have to.
And what are the tips you give to people when they're doing something like that?
Probably the biggest tip is to take time, to calm down, be slow, have someone out around you looking at the car and looking what's going on, looking at the wheels that you can't see. To take your time and not panic, even when things go not quite the way you want. There's a lot of tips and a lot of techniques out there that you can use to get yourself through without damaging the vehicle.
But the park is not reserved purely for four-wheel drives. There is plenty more going on and big plans for the future. Kareem Duncan is one of the owners of this family-run business and excited about the potential of this property. She also puts on a great barbecue.
Kareem, thanks for this food. Terrific.
No worries.
It's funny how four-wheel driving builds up an appetite.
Absolutely does.
Now, what do you do out here in the way of catering and other facilities?
Well, we've got this beautiful area here that is available for corporate events and things like that. So we have a lot of corporates come out and launch their vehicles and four-wheel drive vehicles and things like that. But we don't just have this area. We've got other beautiful areas further up in the mountains as well with an outside camp kitchen and things like that. So some beautiful areas and obviously beautiful views to look at.
What other hills are back there?
The Lamington National Park.
While she may still be learning the lay of the land, one thing Kareen has learned from years managing these types of venues is how to keep visitors entertained. There's plans for ropes courses and flying foxes, walking tracks and much, much more.
We've also introduced mountain bike tracks as well now. We've got an area for the remote control rock crawling. For kids and for adults, the big kids love to play those as well. A BMX track we set up for the kids, so you know it's a place where families can come. So you know, dad and mum can go four-wheel driving, or mum can sit back at the campsite and read a book while the kids have a play as well. So plenty of stuff to do for everybody.
Scenic Rim Adventure Park is in Innes Plain, about an hour and a half from Brisbane. Four-wheel drive day trip entry is $35, and camping is $8 per night. The next Suspension Stuff Challenge will be held on the 13th of October, and the big event, the Off-Road Boss King of the Rim, from the 16th to the 18th of November.
It's fair to say the Sunshine Coast hinterland has become famous for its food, from the produce itself to the manufacturers through to the restaurants. So what better way to get amongst all the foodie action than to go to the source of where much of it's produced? At the Real Food Festival in Mullaney. It's all happening on the second weekend in September. Ahead on the show, Champs discovers Brisbane's rich music scene.
What do you have for us? Every day is so
wonderful. And suddenly. She's an actress, not a waitress. It's hard to breathe. I think she's a star.
5, 6, 7, 8. Don't you bring me down
today. There's something about her. She glows with it.
What a voice!
We worry. It's so competitive, all that rejection.
It's spectacular work. Don't you bring me down.
You're great in this.
In
the wake of disaster, two are dead. But has someone discovered big storms are the perfect way to hide murders?
Wind, hail, rain, Mother Nature destroys the crime scene.
Now, two thrilling times a week.
As this weather gets worse, so will the answer.
New Criminal Minds, tonight and Wednesday on 7.
Heading to Asia? With over 150 destinations, Flight Centre's got you covered. Any airline, any destination, we'll get you there. Fly return to Bali from $609. Phuket from $837. Or Bangkok and Krabi from $899. And remember, we'll beat any airfare quote or you fly free.
Call Flight Centre Lewis Hill, the guarantee.
Call 131-600.
Some car insurance companies may provide features like a no-claims bonus and payment options. Others include cover for multiple drivers, multi-policy discounts and flood cover. But only RACQ Comprehensive Car Insurance gives you all of these, plus a driver excellence bonus, free Aussie assist and up to an additional 15% off for club members. For comprehensive car insurance you can trust from Queensland's largest club, call 13 1905 today.
For everything marine under the one roof, get to the Brisbane Boat Show. All your favourite brands in Queensland's biggest marine showroom. Don't miss the Brisbane Boat Show, 23rd to the 26th of August at the Brisbane Convention and Exhibition Centre, South Bank.
Are you under financial pressure? Is it affecting your life and relationships? My Budget can help. In a free, no-obligation consultation, My Budget can create a budget plan to get you back on track. mybudget.com.au.
You'll wait for me, won't you?
Probably not.
Don't like to wait? Join Medibank Hospital and Extras by August 31 to claim straight away on most extras, plus get 1 month free. Choose the insurance your health deserves. Get in touch with Medibank today.
Test drive Pizza Caper's new easy-to-use online ordering system and you could be driving away in a brand new Mini Cooper. Just order any of our amazing pizzas online with a 1.25-litre soft drink to go in the draw. Pizza Caper's. Order online and you could win a Mini.
Tuesday on Winners and Losers.
Please. What have we got?
One of their lives will hang in the balance.
Claire.
New Winners and Losers, Tuesday.
So what is it that makes a city like Brisbane so great? Some might say it's the weather. Others might say it's the beautiful Moreton Bay or the booming restaurant and cafe scene. But for me, it has to be its awesome soundtrack.
Every year, Brisbane plays host to a series of music festivals that attract the hottest acts from across Australia and around the world. And from the 12th to the 14th of September, Fortitude Valley will be home to the annual Big Sound Live Music Festival. There will be 12 venues within a four-block radius, and one of those will be Black Bear Lodge in the Valley Mall. Today, it's where I'm meeting the festival programmer, Graham Ashton.
Why is Brisbane so good to host festivals like this?
I think historically, Brisbane's just always fought outside of its weight division musically in such a big way. You know, you just have to look to the 70s to bands like the Saints and the Go-Betweens, and then the 90s, you know, with Powderfinger and Regurgitator and bands like that. I've always believed it's the cost of living and the lifestyle's a lot easier for artists to kind of take their time, and maybe the environment's a little less competitive and more community.
Around 120 acts are on the bill, and for those looking to hear newer local talent, you won't leave disappointed. Thomas Calder is a young Brisbane musician who calls himself The Trouble with Templeton. This year will be his first time performing at Big Sound Live.
What can we expect at the festival?
Hopefully a good show. I don't know, yeah. We're all going to be very, very excited and very happy to be there, so hopefully a fun, good, rockin' show.
Big Sound Live will be showcasing everything from hip-hop to country music, and Thomas is bringing his own folk rock sound.
How does one pick their genre, really?
I don't think you do. I think other people pick it for you, or at least in my case. I just sort of don't try to think about a genre or anything specific, just make music and then people sort of tell you what they think it is.
I'd sell my soul for a dime or two. It is getting old. I'll never demerge you.
That's Thomas. Unplugged, baby. Yeah.
Unplugged.
Good job.
Can see more of that at Big Sound.
There you go, right there.
Big Sound Live is only a few weeks away, and tickets can be purchased from the festival website. A one-day pass costs $50 and a two-day pass costs $75. Sean Graham is another Brisbane local who loves music. So he and a few mates created the Red Deer Festival, which is held annually at Mount Sampson.
Sean, why did you start up your own festival?
Well, all the organisers are all Brizzy boys, and basically we've loved going to music festivals up and down the east coast of Australia, and having to travel an hour north or an hour south, we realised that there's a bit of a market in Brisbane to having our own camping BYO festival, so that sort of kicked it all off, yeah, about 4 years ago.
So tell us a little bit about what goes on.
Well, basically, Red Deer is a boutique BYO camping music festival about 35 minutes from Brisbane CBD. The music kicks off about 11 a.m. in the morning and goes right through till midnight. So it's a full day of live music and really great times with mates.
This year there's an awesome selection of musical talent lined up, ranging from unsigned Southeast Queensland musos right up to famous Aussie groups like Regurgitator. Unfortunately, tickets have sold out, but you can listen to the festival live on 4ZZZ Radio. And it'll be on again next year, so I suggest you keep your eye on the website for all the latest info. Whilst you're online, why don't you check out the website for some more upcoming Brisbane music festivals. Park Life will be held on September 29th from noon at the City Botanic Gardens and River Stage. And just a few months later, on the 18th of November, the Harvest Music Festival will also occupy the Botanic Gardens. Acts will include Beck and Sigur Rós.
Brisbane will be joining cities around the world for a unique event, Le Dîner en Blanc. A multitude of people dressed all in white will convene on one of Brisbane's premier locations, which is kept secret until the big night, for a mass picnic. The concept was born in Paris 24 years ago and has since swept the world, making a name for itself as the epitome of sophistication. There'll be decadence, dining and dancing with hordes of new friends. The evening is invite only, so it's crucial to register online. And if you're not lucky enough to get a ticket this time round, then it's worth finding the location on the night just to see the spectacle that is Le Dîner en Blanc.
This is a really great self-guided walk and a wonderful way to discover Yamundi. Everything is nice and close to each other and it's so charming. I think one of the reasons that Yamundi's retained its charm is because of all the original architecture. Have a look at Joe's Waterhole over my shoulder. They've been quenching thirsts there for over 120 years. But today, all the action is across the street. I'll take you to the Yamundi markets after the break.
Hello, next in 7 News, residents on alert after a backburn jumps containment lines. The traffic light plan to ease Brisbane's peak hour congestion. An exclusive tour of the Legacy Way project as it reaches a major milestone. An accused drunk driver destroys an Ipswich War Memorial. Fears a river tourist attraction could be lost to Brisbane. And in flashback, the car meant to run on water, why scientists called it a hoax.
Get in the mood for the Kath and Kim movie with a relaxing spa.
Oh, hello, Wayne.
Sex bomb, sex bomb. You're my sex bomb. You can give it to me when I need.
Kath and Kim, the souvenir edition. Tonight, 7:30 on 7.
At Energy Australia, we're determined to help our customers be more energy efficient. And to help us create more efficient energy solutions, we're heading out to understand how customers use their energy. The more we know, the more we can help.
Fire!
Perfect landing.
What do you expect from your home insurance company?
I'd like the best cover at the best price.
We tailor-make your home insurance, because at UE, we get what you expect from us. Call us on 136 836 or go to ue.com.au and see for yourself.
Suncorp Bank is treating new customers to a $50 bonus. So, how will you spend your $50?
Hot chips.
$50 bonuses. Now there's a treat.
I'm so embarrassed. I've wasted thousands of dollars just because I didn't know.
Dave's just bought a new car, but he didn't know that the Cherry J3 was just $14,990 and the Cherry SUV is just $17,990.
I could have saved thousands.
Cherry, why would you pick anything else?
One thing doctors use an ultrasound scan for is to date your pregnancy. Clear Blue Digital is the only pregnancy test that also tells you how far along you are, weeks before your scan. Clear Blue, confidence when you need it most.
Swing in a McDonald's for a Happy Meal. Get a chicken snack wrap, apple slices and a calcium milk. Plus a cool toy from the new movie Madagascar 3. You could even win a family holiday to meet the Madagascar characters at DreamWorld's new DreamWorks experience. See happymeal.com.au for terms and conditions.
The township of Yamundi is a small, close-knit community in the Sunshine Coast hinterland, about 2 hours north of Brisbane. On any other day, you could describe it as a quiet and peaceful place. But come Wednesdays and Saturdays, the town's overrun by hundreds of visitors.
It all started back in 1979 when a local ceramic artist had a light bulb moment. He wanted to create a European-style market here in Yamundi, but that first attempt was hardly the grand bazaar. There was a total of 3 stalls and 8 visitors. As you can see, though, things have certainly changed.
Now, with over 600 stalls and an estimated 1.6 million visitors a year, it's the biggest art and craft market in Australia.
How cute are these?
Yamundi is definitely an area that fosters creativity, and the market's ethos, we make it, bake it, grow it, sew it, is a mantra that rings true. It's great to see that while the number of stall holders has grown, traditional art forms remain timeless.
Tell me about how you create these.
Well, I managed to develop this of putting different clays together which have different shrinkage rates.
Ceramic artist Kiki Vasiliou has been moulding and shaping clay creations for over 25 years. She's been a regular at markets for the last 2 decades, where her distinctive style has always remained popular.
The lights are pretty, they're my favourites, I have to say, and it's nice to have some vibrant colours around, but then you've got these nice neutral shades.
Why choose the Yamundi markets to be able to share your wares?
Because they're probably the best markets in the world. As I recently went to Tasmania and went to the, not to say anything nasty about the market, they weren't as good as here. They didn't have the handicrafts that we have, and they didn't have that sort of community feeling that we have here.
What is it that you particularly love yourself as a shopper here at the markets?
Well, as a shopper, I find that because there's so many different unique things here and because they're handcrafted by the person selling them, I find that I don't need to go anywhere else.
Winding my way through the markets, the variety is staggering, but one constant is the friendly faces greeting you, like Terry, who's been part of the Yamundi markets for almost 30 years, and it's now a family affair, with his sons also running stalls.
Now that's a drill put to good use.
Marketing manager Peter Holman is another character you're likely to encounter. A veritable celebrity around here, he's distinguishable by his red trilby hat and the fact that he knows everyone.
It's amazing that in the space of literally 20 metres you've got pretty much the entire world covered when it comes to food.
We sure do, don't we? We have Japanese and Italian, French, Spanish,
Argentinian.
Mexican, Argentinian, yeah.
So amazing that people are so eager to try different foods now. I bet it wasn't like that 11 years ago when you first started at these markets.
It wasn't, and we didn't have this, we didn't even have the range of food. You know, there wasn't very much cooked food at all. It was mostly produce, but now there's a lot of cooked international flavours, which is wonderful.
As well as food stands, there are cooking demonstrations. The Market Chef competition is now in its second year and sees participants from local schools guided by top chefs. School teams then cook off against one another using seasonal ingredients. It seems while the setting is an historic one, the markets are continuing to grow and evolve with the times.
Do you still love it as much as you did when you first started?
Even more, I think. Yeah, even more. I mean, I've seen it grow and we're one big family. It's like one community growing together and we all know each other really well. We know each other's children, we know each other's family.
Now, I can't help but notice over your shoulder is something I've actually never tried before. It says Brazilian sticks, the flavours of Brazil. What's a Brazilian stick?
Aren't they wonderful?
I don't know.
Well, it's like a batter and with all the beautiful fresh ingredients like mushrooms and feta cheese and spinach, and you bake it almost.
It looks delicious. Let's go to Brazil. Wow, that's fantastic. Well, there's enough to share. Would you like a little
Look
bit?
At that. Yes, I'd love some. Thank you.
Gluten-free too.
Take your taste buds around the globe and explore the world's largest arts and craft market at Yamundi. Opened Wednesdays and Saturdays. For more ideas of things to do while you're on the Sunshine Coast or anywhere in southeast Queensland, the RACQ, Queensland Holidays and Queensland Rail Travel websites are all great resources.
The Yamundi markets may be best known for their arts and crafts, but as you can see, there's all that and a whole lot more. And after a full day of exploring, I could think of no better way than to finish up here, treating myself to a little massage. Hope we've given you some inspiration to head out and explore the markets for yourself. And I do hope you can join us all next time as we take you on a new journey to our little southeast corner of Queensland that we call the Great Southeast. We'll see you then.
The Great Southeast has a proud partnership with Tourism Queensland and with Queensland Rail and RACQ. The Motorama Group keeps us all on the move.
In the first 3 minutes of X Factor, you'll hear something incredible. No Australian performance show has discovered anything like this. Don't miss the first 3 minutes of X Factor, tomorrow 7:30.
There are any number of reasons.